Hare Krishna. Today we shall be reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, 7th Canto, Chapter 7, What Prahlada Learned in the Womb of Mother. Text number 24 we are going to recite. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskritya. Naram Jaiva Narottamam. Devim Saraswatim Vyasam. Tado Jayamudiraye. Nashtaprayeshu Abhadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Uttama Sloge Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtake. Text number 24. Anvaya Vyatirekena Vivekena Usatat Atmana Swarga Stana Samanaye Vimrishyadve Asatvaraihi Anvaya Vyatirekena Vivekeno Satatmana Swargasthana Samamnaya Vimarshabdira Satvarai Anvaya Vyatirekena Vivekena Satatmana Swargasthana Samamnaya Vimrishabdira Satvarai Anvaya Vyatirekena Vivekeno Satatmana Swargasthana Samamnaya Vimrishabdira Satvarai Anvaya directly Vyatirekena and indirectly Vivekena by mature discrimination Usata purified Atmana with the mind Swarga creation Sthana maintenance Samanmaya and with the destruction Vimrishadbihi by those making a serious analysis. Asatvaraihi, very sober. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami, Srila Prabhupada Ki. Sober and expert persons should search for the spirit soul with the minds purified through analytical study in terms of the soul's connection with and distinction from all things that undergo creation, maintenance and destruction. Kindly repeat translation. Sober and expert persons should search for the spirit soul with the minds purified through analytical study in terms of the soul's connection with and distinction from all things that undergo creation, maintenance and destruction. Purport by Stephen Gaze. A sober person can study himself and distinguish the soul from the body by analytical study. For example, when one considers his body, his head, his hands and so on, one can certainly understand the difference between the spirit soul and the body. No one says I head, everyone says my head. Thus there are two entities, the head and I. They are not identical, although they appear to be one conglomeration. One may argue, when we analyze the body, we find a head, hands, legs, a belly, blood, bones, urine, stool, and so on. But after everything is considered, where is the existence of the soul? A sober man, however, avails himself of this Vedic instruction. Yato va imani bhutani jayante yena jatani jivanti yat prayanti api samshavishanti tat vijnana savswa tad brahmeti. Taittiriya Upanishad 3.1.1. Thus he can understand that the head, hands, legs and indeed the entire body have grown on the basis of the soul. If the soul is within the body, head, hands and legs grow, but otherwise they do not. A dead child does not grow up, for the soul is not present. If by a careful analysis of the body, one still cannot find the existence of the soul, this is due to his ignorance. How can a gross man fully engaged in materialistic activities understand the soul, which is a small particle of spirit, 1/10,000th the size of the tip of the hair? Such a person foolishly thinks that the material body has grown from a combination of chemicals. Although he cannot find them, the Vedas inform us, however, that the chemical combinations do not constitute the living force. The living force is the Atma and Paramatma, and the body grows on the basis of that living force. The fruit of a tree grows and undergoes six kinds of change because of the presence of the tree. If there were no tree, there could be no question of the growth and maturity of fruit. Therefore, beyond the existence of the body are the Paramatma and the Atma within the body. This is the first understanding of spiritual knowledge explained in Bhagavad Gita. Dehinosmin yatha dehe. The body exists because of the presence of the Supreme Lord and the Jiva, which is a part of the Lord. This is further explained by the Lord himself in Bhagavad Gita 9.4. Maya tadamidam sarvam jagat avyakta murtina mastani sarva bhudani nachagam teshuvastitaha. By me, in my unmanifested form, this entire universe is pervaded. All beings are in me, but I am not in them. The Supreme Soul exists everywhere. The Vedas enjoin sarvam khalu idam brahma. Everything is Brahman, or an expansion of Brahman's energies. Sutre manigana iva. Everything rests on the Lord. Just like pearls strung together on a thread, the thread is the principal Brahman. He is the supreme cause and the supreme Lord upon whom everything rests. mataha paradaram nanyata. Thus we must study the Atma and Paramatma, the individual soul and the super soul, upon whom the entire material cosmic manifestation rests. This is explained by the Vedic statement, yato va imani bhutani jayante yena jatani jivanti. Thus and the purport by His Divine Grace, Sri Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada ki. Om ajnana timirandasya jnanajnana shalagaya chakshurun milidam yena tasmai shri guruve namaha mugangaro divachalam bangum langayade girim yatkribadamaham mande shri gurum dinadaranam paramanandamadavam krishna chaitanyeshwaram hare krishna 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 hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishnaya Vasudevaya, Devaki Nandanaya cha, Nandagopakumaraya, Govindaya namo namaha, Govindaya namo namaha. Govindaya namo namaga namaga pankajanabhaya namaga pankajamaline namaga pankajanetraya namaste pankajangraye Hare Krishna.
We are in the session of Srimad Bhagavatam. This particular chapter describing what Prahlad Maharaj learned in the womb of his mother. So for the last few days we are hearing actually so when he was actually in the womb of his mother, he himself is telling the story to his classmates, friends, the leisure time. This was his discussion actually. Because they asked actually, how Prahlad, you are a small boy, how you attained this particular position? How you are able to do all these things in the midst of your teachers are teaching you economic development, politics, and father is insisting that you should study that. He is against Lord Vishnu. So in the midst of all these things, from where did you learn all these things? How you are able to speak? So in answer to that, he is actually explaining what happened to him when he was in the womb of mother. And Narada Muni took care of his mother, because she was taken away by Indra because of its ignorance. And Narada Muni kept her in the ashram, and he started actually giving the transcendental knowledge about the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Bhagavan. So there is one point yesterday also we were discussing, that he said, my mother being a lady, she could not understand, she could not remember all these things. But I could remember all these things, even though I was in the womb, I could hear it, only because of the mercy of Narada Muni. He blessed me. So this is a catch point actually for us. If we want to understand the transcendental subject matter, which the Lord Himself is giving or His devotees are giving, we require actually the mercy of the Lord, mercy of Guru, mercy of Vaishnavas. Blessing is required, actual blessing is required. Then only it is possible. So he started speaking actually. So I was thinking actually, you know, of our Arjuna's situation initially. it was very bad. He started speaking to Krishna that I cannot kill my relatives, I cannot do anything on my guru. So many things will happen if we kill in the battle. So Krishna wanted to give him the transcendental knowledge. In the second chapter, Bhagavad Gita onwards, he actually started speaking to him. 2:13 onwards, Prabhupada has quoted here. Dehi nosmin yatha dehe kaumaram yavanam jara tatha dehantara prapti dhiras tatrana mukhyadi. Become dhira. Whatever I am telling you, if you want to understand, you know, you should understand actually you are not his body. You are soul, part and parcel of Krishna. So there are so many verses explaining only about the Atma, which is within Arjuna. When he has got his knowledge, he is transformed. Finally he said, Karishye Vajananda, whatever you say, Krishna, I will do it. I have no words. So anybody in this material world, either the Supreme Lord or the devotees of the Lord, great Vaishnavas, they want to change somebody. You know, our preaching, ISKCON preaching, is based on teachings of Lord Chaitanya, spoken by Srila Prabhupada. So he has given a set of instruction, he has given a set of things. We preach to anyone that, as Prabhupada has mentioned here, the ABCD of the spiritual knowledge is to tell them, make the people understand that you are not his body. You are spirit soul. So here Prahlad Maharaj also, he started speaking because he heard from Narada Muni. The same knowledge he is imparting to his friends. Now why it is there repeatedly in Srimad Bhagavatam and different chapter Kando? Because the basic knowledge should the message should go through. If they want, they definitely become a, you know, self-realized. Only we are actually only talking about self-realization. That self-realization will come only when one understands. Not only here, they have to understand actually what it is. So today, he has explained here about the spirit-soul difference between body and the soul. And Narada Muni must have told him that analytical study is required. Many people has got a doubt actually, where is the soul? We say that just like a two birds, it is there inside the heart, is sitting there. Soul and the super soul, Atma and Paramatma, which is actually the essence of this body actually. Everything is happening because of their presence there. So everybody has got first of all, Prabhupada is mentioning here that nobody says that I head, says that my head. My head means there is somebody other than the head. I am not the head. There is somebody, my head, this is my hand, not I hand. That means there is somebody called my inside. He is the authority, he is the owner of this. And says, this is my head, this is your head. So, that shows that it is different. Body and the soul is different. It is not one and the same. So this example is very, very good here actually to understand. My head, my hand, my leg, like that. And then somebody is doing the analytical study, then he may take the different component of the body. Say somebody is doing a postmortem of the body. Okay. Say for studying purpose. Then he separates all the components of the body. And they cannot see actually the the soul in it, super soul in it. Super soul is actually ఈ పరమాత్మ ఈ ఇట్ ఈస్ మెన్షన్ ఇన్ ద శాస్త్ర ఇట్ హెస్ కోడ్ ఎ ఫామ్ 400 ఫామ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ సైజ్ ఆల్సో ఇస్ మెన్షన్ సో ఇఫ్ ద పరమాత్మ టు రిసైడ్ హౌ ద పరమాత్మ విల్ రిసైడ్ ఇన్ సైడ్ దిస్ బ్లడ్ ఇఫ్ యూ కట్ ఇట్ ఇట్ దేర్స్ అ బ్లడ్ యాక్చువల్లీ ఫ్లెష్ ఈజ్ దేర్ హౌ క్యాన్ ఇది ఎగ్జిస్ట్ ఆన్ దట్ పర్టికులర్ ప్లేస్ సో వన్ గెట్ ఎ డౌట్ అబౌట్ ఇట్ బట్ ప్రభువాద్ ఇస్ మెన్షనింగ్ హియర్ దట్ what is the size of what you are talking about the soul what is the size of the tip of the hair is divided into 10,000 part then you take one part that is the size of the soul so we cannot see with our eyes even they use any scope also I don't think it is able to see that particular portion what is the size of the atma but it is there so whatever Prabhupada says whatever shastra is telling it is truth I don't believe it I have seen it I don't believe it you believe it you don't believe it it is there the effect will be there just like we say that electricity we cannot see the electricity we cannot see with our we can see a switch is there wire is there plug point is there but the bulb when is it is switched on it is lighting effect of the electricity energy but if you cut that wire when switched off cut the wire say where I want to see this electricity you cannot see it but you can see so that is actually the effect of the presence of the atma or paramatma we can experience that is why when atma is there a dead child is not growing the growth is happening only because of the presence of atma part and parcel bhagwan is telling mamai vamsho jeeva loge jeeva bhuta sanatanaha all the living entities are part and parcel of me sarvasya jaham iti sannivishto is not told by anybody else bhagwan himself is telling so we have to have a how it is existing with analytic study you cannot understand actually it is beyond our It is inconceivable. But you can experience when the body, the soul is left the body, it stands still, it gets spoiled. Nobody wants to keep a dead body. After three hours they want to dispose it, which is not good. It is very lovable. So that is the effect of the presence of the I am sitting here and talking, you are sitting here and hearing. Just because that part and parcel of Krishna is there within me or Krishna himself is within me both are there that is why able to speak you are able to hear you are able to understand the so called powerful you know the mind intelligence nothing will work if they are not there so even an example is quoted here the trees are having the fruits the fruit is coming in the small seed like you know it is becoming big and finally become ripen and become very sweet but in between the tree is fallen down or tree is cut or it become dried up so the fruit will not become ripen it will be as it is it also get dried up so because of the tree the presence of atma in that tree only the growth and all the results are coming because of that otherwise it is not possible so other day when I went to the bank so they were telling that whole system is down so we cannot find any even balance we cannot find nothing everybody is sitting idle so I went to the manager I told him I am coming for last 6 months here when I come the printer is out of order this is out of order people are sitting I told him when this it is invented by human being actually this computer and the latest system and I am not telling it is bad before that when human being said we are actually the creation of the Lord that is working perfectly nobody said that I cannot find out your balance because they used to keep a manual register and immediately they could dispose everything that the thing which you created, it is not perfect. The created by the Lord is perfect. There is nothing wrong. So we should not become so much proud, saying that, okay, so much advancements. So, that is because of the presence of the Lord, presence of the Lord, presence of the Lord is not there in the computer. I'm not telling it is bad, but it is not perfect. One day it may come, saying that everything will become standstill. Everybody was sitting, nobody could do any job there. The whole system is down. So similarly, when the Lord presence is not there, everything will come to standstill. And because Bhagavan himself is telling that everything is connected through me. This transcendental knowledge we can see Bhagavan has given to Arjuna very systematically. Narada Muni also given very systematically to Prahlad. That is why he authoritatively, even though he is very small, he could preach. He could deliver that. Second chapter of Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan is giving actually the knowledge about the body and the soul. And he has convinced, I think, that I am not this body, I am the soul. Third chapter of Bhagavad Gita is giving the bit of Karma Yoga. And fourth chapter is giving the transcendental knowledge. And he is giving that this knowledge you cannot get through like that. You have to get through a guru, spiritual master. And how to surrender to him, how to get it. So very systematically he given alert to Arjuna and he became intelligent. He understood the transcendental knowledge, how the system is working, what is our relation with Krishna. So this is possible only when we get actually this knowledge. It is not for simply for reading. It should be understood. So I was just saying actually when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami, actually we are dependent upon Rupa Goswami. We are followers of Rupa Goswami's path. They were actually the ministers in Muslims. Under king, and of course because of they were great personalities, but when they came out, they were actually the materialistic activities they were doing it. After seeing Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they got the knowledge, and when they came out, Bhagavan, the first thing is done for Rupa Goswami. He met him in Prayag, for he took him to Prayag one place, and Rupa Goswami and his brother, and he given this transcendental knowledge to him to change him actually. So we cannot change anybody, a materialistic person to a devotee. Simply it is not possible because the intelligence is given, buddhi is given. So he should be convinced. See, most of our teachings here in our system, people are convinced. After convinced, they are coming to our movement and then they don't leave like that. Intelligent person, they will not leave it because they understood actually the concept. So similarly, anybody wanted to change, Srila Prabhupada changed millions of people by only giving this knowledge. Somebody asked actually to Prabhupada, can you speak about Radharani, the confidential pastime of Radharani? Then he said, okay, bring Bhagavad Gita. He said, first of all, I have to take the class for you, 213. Dehinosmin yadha dehe kaumaram yavanam jara tadha dehandara prapti deh thiras satanam hari. You have to understand this sloga first. You have to become self-realized. Then I can talk about Radharani. Otherwise you cannot understand. You will simply misunderstand the transcendental pastime of the Lord. So the basic knowledge the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given actually to Rupa Goswami. That's not one day or 2 days, 7 days he sat down and he given this particular knowledge. So this is required even for us. These instructions are required for us to change our situation. Even after coming to Krishna consciousness, that he did not understand actually what is Krishna consciousness. How we can do the devotional service for pleasing Krishna. This knowledge is required actually, this jnana is required. That also imparted by the great personalities. The Supreme Personality of Godhead. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Supreme Personality of Godhead. Or Srila Prabhupada. Systematically we have to study and get this knowledge, discuss and make it clear everything. And have faith. Even though I cannot see, I have faith because it is told by so and so. It is in the scriptures, authoritatively. So I thought I will just go through some of the instructions of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu given to Rupa Goswami. It's appropriate in this connection. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu finally arrived at Prayaga and for 10 successive days, bathed in confluence of rivers Yamuna and Ganges during the festival of Makara Sankranti. The first instruction he was giving actually, he said, the ocean of transcendental mellows of devotional service is so big that no one can estimate its length and breadth. However, just to help you taste it, I am describing but one drop. So it is so vast about devotional service, I cannot explain everything for you. I am giving you one drop of it. And he just started speaking to him. Yeda Brahmande Bhari Ananda Jiva Gana Chadrasi Laksha Chaurasi Laksha Yonite Kare Brahmana. In this universe, there are limitless living entities in 8,400,000 species, and all are wandering within this universe. This is actually said, what is your situation? We are also giving the same knowledge. Out of 8,400,000 species of life, we are actually human being is in the top. So he said within the universe actually the jivas are wandering within this 8,400,000 species. The length and breadth of the living entity is described as 1/10,000 part of the tip of the hair. This is the original subtle nature of the living entity. So Mahaprabhu is also giving that first instruction. What is the size? You are, I am so and so, my possession so and so. But who are you? This is your size. That size of the Lord is there within you. That is where everything is happening. If we divide Mahaprabhu is supporting, he has given the quotation. Keshagra sadapagasya sadamcha sadrishatmaga jiva sushma surupoyam Sanghyadi Dohi Chitkanaha. If we divide the tip of the hair into 100 parts and then take one of these parts and divide it again into 100 parts, that very fine division is the size of but one of the numberless living entities. They are all Chitkana, particle of spirit, not matter. So part and parcel of Krishna is not matter, it is spirit. That is your size, Bhagavan is telling. Balagra sadabhagasya sadata kalpitasya ja bhago jiva savijneya iti chaha parasruti. If we divide the tip of the hair into 100 parts and then take one part and divide this into another 100 parts, that 10,000 part is the dimension of the living entity. This is the verdict of the chief Vedic mantras. So Mahaprabhu want actually to understand properly. That is why from different scriptures he is quoting the slogans and telling. I am not telling. Somebody can argue, said anybody has seen the take the measurement of the soul. How you are telling the tip of the head 10,000, then one part. It is there mentioned in the who was created. So one has to have the faith on it. That is your size. Sukshmanam abhyaham jiva. Lord Krishna says, among minute particle, I am the living entity. One of the, anybody you take it, that is one of the entity, part of it. And another sloga is telling, actually the conclusion sloga, the conclusion is that living entities and Supreme Personality of Godhead are one and the same is a faulty conclusion, it is not a fact. Some Mayavadis or some other group of people, they are thinking that actually Supreme Personality of Godhead and the living entities are same. He says that is a faulty, it is not correct. We are only part. The unlimited living entities can be divided into two divisions. Those that can move and those that cannot move. Among the living entities that can move, there are birds, aquatics and animals. So Bhagavan Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is telling actually out of all these 8,400,000, somebody can move, somebody cannot move. Two divisions. Although the living entities known as human beings are very small in quantity, that division may be still further subdivided, for there are many uncultured human beings like Mlechas, Pulindas, Bhautagas and Sabaras. Out of 8,400,000 species, only 400,000 is the only human beings, very few. All others are many. There also, even though it is very small, the divisions may be further subdivided. That small group can be divided into cultured and uncultured. Two type of people. So Mahaprabhu is giving Pulindas, Bahudas, Sabaras, they are uncultured people, we can see. Veda Nishtamati Arthega Veda Mukhe Mani Veda Nishida Papagare Tharmanahi Gane. Among human beings, those who are followers of the Vedic principles are considered civilized. Those who got the faith in Vedas, those scriptures, they are actually the cultured human beings. Among these, almost half simply give up service while committing all kinds of sinful activities against these principles. Such people do not care for the regulative principles. So even though they are born in the civilized part of the human being, just like we say that Chaturvedi, Trivedi, they know all the Vedas by qualification. But he says there is only they do the lip service. Somebody may be speaking, oh, I know all the Vedas, but he doesn't know. And without knowing, only because of the designation, they are proud and they are keep on doing the sinful activities. This is a catch point for us. Even after coming actually to our movement, even after understanding so many things, still people are doing these sinful activities. Prabhupada says, when you come to Krishna consciousness, is the first thing you have to do is stop sinful activities. You are suffering because of the past sinful activities. Even if you want to chant the holy name, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. One has to finish all the past karma, past sinful activities. So whatever is there, it is there. Now onwards, don't do any sinful activities. Or speaking and doing the sinful activities means only lip service. There is no use of it. Because again you are adding. Such people, they do not care about anything. I got a designation saying that I am this, I know all Vedas, I know all the knowledge. But keep on doing the sinful activities, it is okay because I got a designation. But Mahaprabhu says that will not work. Among the followers of Vedic knowledge, most are following the process of fruitive activity and distinguishing between good and bad work. Out of many such sincere fruitive actors, there may be one who is actually wise. So even after coming to the civilized group, getting the knowledge, but they are engaged actually in the fruitive activities. So Bhagavan is telling that, you know, the last instruction, Sarva Dharman Parityaja, Mam Ekam Sharanam Raja, Aham Tam Sarva Bhabibhyo, Moksha Ichami, Masujaha. Surrender unto me. So for that, our literature, actually, there are so many Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam, everybody is telling, actually, you have to renounce something. You have to renounce something. Then only you can get actually attachment with Krishna. If one is keep on doing the fruitive activities, one has come to, say for example, somebody has come to Vrindavan Dham, and still he is actually, instead of realizing that I am in Vrindavan Dham, if I am engaged actually in the fruitive activities, there is no use. You are not considered actually for your advancement or going back home, back to God, it is not possible. So Mahaprabhu says very few. Out of that, there may be actually, there may be one who is wise out of all this understanding that the civilized people, one may be wise. Who is that wise person? Kodi jnani matye haya yega jana mukta, kodi mukta matye durlapa yega krishna bhakta. Out of many millions of such wise men, one may actually become liberated, mukta. And out of many millions of such liberated persons, a pure devotee of Lord Krishna is very difficult to find. So this knowledge is very appropriate, is required for us actually. When we are doing the devotional service, where we stand. He says one may be a wise person. Out of that many wise person, millions of such wise person. Millions of such wise person who understood actually about fruitive activities. One may actually become a liberated mukta. And out of many millions of liberated person, Prabhupada says that even if you chant, you want to chant Hare Krishna, you have to come to the liberated platform. You have to come out of actually purity with that real chanting. I am telling about real chanting of holy name of Krishna. So he is many millions of such liberated person, a pure devotee of Krishna is very difficult to find. We are telling actually you associate with the pure devotees of the Lord. So here Mahaprabhu himself is telling Rupa Goswami, mind you, before you associate, you find out. I am giving you all description. Bhagavan himself is telling. It is very difficult to find one devotee of Krishna, pure devotee of Krishna. Krishna bhakta nishkama ateva shanda bhukti mukti siddhigami sagaliya shanda. Because a devotee of Lord Krishna is desireless, he is peaceful. Fruity workers desire material enjoyment, jnanis desire liberation, and yogis desire material opulence. Therefore, they are all lusty and cannot be peaceful. The peace formula, Bhagavan is also telling in the Bhagavad Gita. Bhaktaram yajna tapasa sarvaloka maheshwaram sugadam sarvabhudanam Nyatva mam shanti michadi. One who simply understands that throughout the entire universe, Krishna is the supreme enjoyer and beneficiary of all kinds of sacrifices, penances and austerities, which should be performed only to attain his devotional service. That Krishna is the supreme being. So those who got this knowledge, they can only become peaceful because their activities will be like that. So because devotee of Lord Krishna is desireless, there is no desire for them, no material desire for him. He is peaceful, shanta. Fruity workers desire material enjoyment, jnanis desire liberation, and yogis desire material opulences. So these are not the ways actually. We have to attach with actually a devotee of Krishna. What is how we can distinguish, how we can find out throughout Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita also, the description is given about a pure devotee. So here is telling that the first symptom is desireless. There is no Krishna bhakta nishkama deva shanta, always is peaceful. So sometime the Srila Prabhupada, when people used to come and, you know, disciples used to come and complain about somebody, you know, Prabhupada is doing like this, he is doing this, doing this. So immediately after hearing, Prabhupada used to take the chanting beats and you will start chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. That is a, you know, the one will not get agitated actually. The devotees, even after hearing so many things, you know, they will believe in Krishna, they have faith in Krishna, they chant the holy name. So the real understanding will come. Then Mahaprabhu is telling, Brahmanda Brahmidekona Bhagyavan Jiva Guru Krishna Prasadipaya Bhaktilata Bija. According to their karma, all living entities are wandering throughout the entire universe. Some of them are being elevated to the upper planetary systems and some are going down into the lower planetary system. Out of many millions of wandering living entities, one who is very fortunate gets an opportunity to associate with a bona fide spiritual master by the grace of Krishna. By the mercy of both Krishna and the spiritual master, such a person receives the seed of the creeper of devotional service. So this is the authoritative way of getting actually the seed of bhakti, seed of devotional service through from a spiritual master. Still in our mission also some people are thinking that actually why we should take initiation, why we should approach a guru. So somebody was telling me that Prabhu, last Kartik only, I got mala, I am chanting actually 64 rounds every day. Prabhu, still I don't have any, you know, nothing in my heart, you know, that bhakti and I can remember Krishna and things like that. So I asked him one question, from where you got this mala? From whom you take the mala? He's not initiated. He says, I took from my stall, somewhere in the stall I took a mala. There's a problem. You have to get the mala from a devotee who is chanting. Get some instructions. Then it will work, one can go. That is why Mahaprabhu is telling actually, the Brahmande Brahmida must have gone to different planetary system and came back, gone up and down, and it is very difficult after many, many births only. One is getting a chance actually to come across a pure devotee of the Lord, a bona fide spiritual master, and get the mercy from him, and seed of devotional service. Then only it will work. These are all the messages for all sorts. Sometimes it is not working on me means something wrong. If everything is okay, what scripture says, it should work nicely. So, when a person receives the seed of devotional service, he should take care of it by becoming a gardener and sowing the seed in his heart. If he waters the seed gradually by the process of sravana and kirtana, hearing and chanting, the seed will begin to sprout. So simply getting initiation and getting a mala is not enough actually. We are telling actually the 10 offenses actually. It is a way of it. Then only it becomes, chanting will become effective. Because there are so many things, maya is so powerful. Mama maya duratiya. He is catching us actually, why you are chanting, come out. You can get this enjoyment. So there is an attack actually, the devotee should put a fence around it. So that it will protect it, protection should be there. He should be take care of the becoming gardener. I will not allow maya to come in within me. I will not go for it strong. So then it will grow. What is actually the fence around? Nirandara chanting and hearing. Sravanam Kirtanam Vishnu, Smaranam Bada Sevanam. That is what Prahlad Maharaj, we are studying actually, he is going to tell. That is actually, he is going to tell his friends. This is a way how you can protect your actually the devotional service you are doing. It will not get contaminated, because he says that all our devotional service should be uncontaminated. It should be pure. And this sloka also said, you have to purify your heart. All this process, all Bhagavatam says, Sravanam and Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, hearing and chanting about the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Bhagavan. So there are so many advices like this, very wonderful. Mahaprabhu is finally telling actually, yes, you have to immerse in actually in Krishna consciousness. Nirantara actually, always chanting, always hearing, all our, that is why a pure devotee is a symptom is like that. He will be always chanting. Because Rupa Goswami, when he came, One devotee, Vallabha, he introduced, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu introduced him and he wanted to hug him. Then Rupa Goswami said, "Don't touch me, I am Mlecha, you know, actually I was working there, don't touch me." Then Mahaprabhu also said, "You are a Vedic, you are a Brahmana, you should not touch him, you know, he is telling you, no, don't do that." Then he was telling him, "Mahaprabhu, you only taught me, then now I am telling you the same thing. These two persons actually, I saw that continuously they are chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. How can it become contaminated? They are not contaminated." So to remove the contamination, actually, nirantara, actually, continuous process of devotional service of chanting and hearing, wherever we get a chance actually to sit down and discuss Krishna Katha. Now we are actually very near to Krishna Janmashtami. So we are actually fully engaged. If you want actually to fast on the day or do the devotional service, we should be immersed actually remembering about Krishna, Krishna's pastime, Krishna's birth, appearance. So some of the slogans we can by heart it and glorify him. This will give us the enough strength actually, protect our actually devotional service. Krishna will help us. This is what Krishna also wanted. Mahaprabhu also wanted the same thing. Even is Krishna only. You don't waste your time. Even a fraction of a second should be utilized after coming to Krishna consciousness. Something related to Krishna we should be doing actual activities. And remember, anything which we are doing, remember Krishna, Krishna in the center. That is Krishna consciousness. That is why Mahaprabhu is keep on explaining. After hearing that, Rupa Goswami was not the earlier person. He changed himself. He came to Vrindavan. He said, "You go to Vrindavan." He started writing actually the wonderful books, you know, he has written. They are following that. And we know that even he guided A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, Radha Damodar Temple. He got darshan of Rupa Goswami. That is why what we are getting here, all the purports and everything is writings. All the blessings of Rupa Goswami has blessed completely Prabhupada. That is why he could write for us. We can read it, understand it and release it. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. One question? Sorry? Relation between the body and the soul. Body and the soul. See, just like a machine, suppose there is a beautiful, you know, you got a cooler, air cooler or something has come, okay? When you connect with the electricity switch on, it starts functioning. Correct? All our dharma, we are able to do it, you know, you are using your senses, breathing, so many activities, just like a machine. Bhagavan is telling, Antaragrahadi Maya, it is just like a machine, it is working. When the presence of the Lord is there, that is just like electricity, everything will become alive. Okay? Just compare with the electricity. When it is connected, when the Atma goes, it dead. No activity, it will not grow. It gets spoiled, correct? If something we cook, very nice prasadam, something like that, if we keep inside the fridge, it will not get spoiled. But if you take it out and keep it outside, it gets spoiled, correct? Similarly, this body is like this because of the presence of the Lord. Okay? And it is actually Prakriti. We got, this is the karma phala of our previous activities. Accordingly, the difficulties will come, even though presence of the Lord is there. But he is also instructing how to get rid of it. You can be a fit man. Come on, you surrender unto me. But we don't want to understand, we don't want to do it. So that reactions are coming. Okay? Yeah. Mataji is... Yeah, there is actually, Prabhupada said actually everyone who is chanting, they will get some promotion. Some promotion you will get it, but not the perfection. And Hare Krishna devotees, we are actually struggling, working hard for what? To finish our business here and go back home, back to Kotak. For that only we have to come to the perfection. Chanting, you will get some benefit, definitely you will get. Even if one time somebody said Hare Krishna, Prabhupada, our Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said he is considered as a Vaishnava. He gets some benefit. But perfection you will not get it unless until, you know, we concentrate that the lotus feet of the Lord or the particular form of the Lord should come within your heart and be in touch with the Lord and calling Him. That is a perfect chanting actually. And it is wandering, mind is wandering because here Mahaprabhu said you have become desireless. You know, what at the end of the day, what is coming in your mind is throughout the day what activities you are doing. You are quarreling with somebody or reading something else, hearing something else, then it will come. Suppose you attend actually a very nice sankirtan. Somebody is singing melodious kirtan and you are enjoying actually. Even if the kirtan is finished, when you go home, the same tune will come in your mind. Correct? You'll be keep on chanting. So it all depends upon us. That is why he said, Nirandara. Continuously, we should try to engage in the service of the Lord or discuss with the devotees, like-minded devotees, about Krishna. Krishna Katha should be there. Then we'll be able to concentrate our mind. Okay? Hare Krishna. Okay, arrange.